I'm sure people will look in earlier parts of that and find some problems, you know, if they want to try to twist scripture, but, you know, this is usually what is pointed to. Verse 26, for if we sin willfully, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remaineth no more sacrifice for sins, but a certain fearful looking for of judgment and fiery indignation, which shall devour the adversaries. You know, Paul's like, don't go backwards, look forwards. It's the same thing. You know, we can look at Galatians. That's exactly what they were saying in the book of Galatians when Paul was talking to the church of Galatia. We look at Galatians 4. Now I say that the heir, as long as he is a child, and this is verse 1, differeth nothing from a servant, though he be Lord of all, but is under tutors and governors until the time appointed of the Father. Even so, we, when we were children, were in bondage under the elements of the world. But when the fullness of the time was come, God sent forth his Son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. And because ye are sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of his Son into your hearts, crying, Abba, Father. Wherefore thou art no more a servant, but a son, and if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. Howbeit that then, when ye knew not God, ye did service unto them, which by nature are no gods. But now, after that ye have known God, or rather are known of God, how turn ye again to the weak and beggarly elements, whereunto ye desire again to be in bondage? Ye observe days and months and times and years. I'm afraid of you, lest I bestowed upon you labor in vain. So Paul is saying the same exact thing to the Galatians. They were trying to get back under the laws, observing days and the Sabbath and months and times and years and doing all these works. And he was getting on to him. He's like, why do you want to get back under those beggarly elements? You put your trust in Jesus Christ. You know God through the person of Jesus Christ, and he knows you. Don't get back under those laws. Don't get back under that. You're mixing right back in with those who have not acknowledged the truth and are still under the bondage of the law. They're still servants, and they're following the law and following the people that are instructing them to do the law. It hasn't got them to the point to acknowledge the truth of Jesus Christ and receive him as their Savior. So don't get back into that mix. And that's what he's saying here. Don't get back into that mix.